traveling.
At the first moment of a lover's encounter, there's an affirmation of love. Psychologically, lunacy, emptiness, panic, delusion that the moment will last forever. I'm seized by desire. I hide behind my back and post Malone answers.
Hello everyone. Welcome back to my flop and boring channel, hehe. So I will share my thoughts on the recent Billie debut song, which is now probably the most hated 4th gen girl group debut ever. But did I hate it like everyone else? No. Did I actually love it? Yes. Did I like it at first listen? Yes. Everyone was hating it everywhere, from the timeline to reviews to comments, literally everywhere. But me? I actually loved it. I understood it at first listen. It was very good. I'm probably embodying that, just making sure I don't fit in meme now, but I don't care. I just love it. Really, really love it. So let's start from the pre-release contents. When the Village of Perception Chapter 1 teaser dropped and saw it on my timeline, I knew I had to tune in because the concept is really interesting. But not just the concept, I expect the music will sound very, very good because they're from Mystic. As a brown-eyed girls and part-time IU and Sunny Hill stan, I knew I had to tune in and support these girlies. And then I was hooked teaser after teaser. Those chapter films were really amazing, and the lore they want to show is really interesting as well. And those subtle song cameos within scenes, I was getting hyped because all those songs so good. And then there we have it with the B-side spoiler, which confused me because it sounded like what I expected to be the title, and the choreo has those hand telephone movements. So are they trying to fool me? But anyways. The music video teaser dropped, and there the polarizing opinions started to emerge. People were saying, and there my expectations go, and they were scared it might sound really bad and just going to sound like a generic angsty 4th gen song. MHM, I don't know, but I was already expecting it to sound like that, because those alarm and sinister background music was being repeated so much in those chapter films, and I like those sounds. I will always love a horror soundtrack masterpiece, so I did not have any doubts it will sound bad. Then the highlight medley dropped. Everyone was saying the B-side sound good and might sound better than the actual title, which I actually kind of agree because I really fell in love with Everybody's Got a Secret and so excited to hear it in full, but all the tracks were really good. And by the way, the title is produced by Sunny Hill brown-eyed girls IU hitmaker Lee Minsu, who is probably my most fave K-pop producer just beside Sweettune. So I already knew it was going to sound as a hit as well. And then the long-awaited music video and mini album arrived. Okay, first, the music. I love it. I was getting very confused and thrilled in a good way, like the song just keeps building and building up. I was enjoying every second. The mixing kinda sounds off at the chorus, but I don't know anything about mastering or mixing, so who am I to think what I was hearing or saying is right, lol. But that grew on me after a single listen. I loved the horror feels of the song, the sirens and alarm and everything. It sounds like it came from a horror movie. And I love hearing horror soundtracks, which is why I instantly liked it. The songs is very cohesive and unique and complicated and experimental, but on top of all that, it was very amazing to me. Next, the music video. I think the budget was spent so much on the pre-release stuffs, cuz why is the music video 90% choreography scenes? Like, what about the lore, the story? I don't know anymore. That's probably the only thing I would have wanted more. I'm too lazy to say my thoughts about every B-side, so I'll just briefly say my thoughts. Flipping a coin. Kinda expected more, but it's a good club hit, so I'm fine with it. Floored. Amazing ballad. What if the next title sounds like this, giving us early IU music? Oh, I'm excited. The 11th day. Amazing light jazz hit, very lovely. Everybody's Got a Secret. Amazing, amazing, flawless and amazing. The Rumor. Kinda expected more as well, but it's a good Latin club hit as well, so I like it. This mini album was very good. I'll score it 10 out of 10. So let's go now to the reception. Everyone in the TL was saying it's trash except for a very few people, like only 11 people. Okay, Billy reference. Well, I think it was very expected it will get polarizing opinions, because the producer and people in charge love to release boundary pushing and avant-garde songs, so you wouldn't all get it. From the works of IU, Sunny Hill and Brown Eyed Girls, you can definitely see that direction. Anyways, some of you will love I'll haters, so I will be hateful this short moment. Hating on Ring by Ring, when you love snoozer K-pop songs like Maverick by The Boys, Mayfair in the Morning by ITZY, Cinema by Six and more I will not be naming, because I don't want this hateful energy inside me. I really hate to be this hateful, so now the soul of Billy will be leaving my body. But yeah, you see the point, if I even made a point, cause I don't know as well LMAO. I'm sorry for the slanders I've said in advance. Harem, Hiruna, Moonswa, Tsuki, Suhyeon and Suyeon, we love you. I'm excited to hear more good music from you, and more amazing concepts, thank you. When we get an electropop hit next comeback that sounds similar to Abracadabra. When we get an orchestral hit like Good Day, You and I, The Red Shoes or Sixth Sense. When we get so much more amazing songs. I'm very excited, that's why I've become a Billy fan, since day one of pre-release stuffs. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.